Hello everyone, how you doing? Welcome back to my channel. And if you're just coming by for the first time, you're most definitely welcome. I can tell from this video, I am so excited. I mean, at this point, I am literally doing a shameless vlog right now. And that's because we're talking about Luca Measure, guys. So we're talking about Luca Measure and literally how to get started with Luca Measures, right? And what is Luca Measure? So I'll literally guide you through everything about Luca Measures and how to even create measures in Luca, right? And I know that it seems like there's really little no tutorial out there regarding how to use Luca, and personally for me it was something that I had to like struggle with and also learn on the job as well too, because there was not so much content out there. And then again, because everyone person who wants to come to data analytics pretty much either doing Power BI or what, Tableau. So we had little or no content out there, and granted that's probably because for the tool itself you literally have to, it's not like so accessible per se, but it is accessible. So I'll be showing you how to also do that, and also in my previous video I also showed you as well to how to even build a dashboard, right? And I would link the video probably somewhere here. I'm actually doing this video because I really hope there was even an extensive video to literally guide a newbie looking to get started or to even use Google Luca, right? And I literally had to learn all this on the job, and seeing that many people out there have started adopting Google Luca and a lot of companies are looking to even use Google Luca moving forward, it just makes sense for me to come and literally share one or two tips I've learned, right, using Google Luca. And one tool, or rather one feature in Google Luca that I mean you literally use on a day-to-day basis is literally the measures, right? And measures is nothing but your aggregation. So think about how you perform your count, your sum, your average, your distinct, whatever you do in Power BI or in Tableau, you can do that in Google Luca. But I don't know why I prefer calling it Google Luca. But we're going to get started and we're going to really jump right into this. To get started, we're going to use something called Quick Labs, right? Because compared to just Power BI on as to how you can just download the application on your desktop, here in Google Luca, you literally have to sign in using your Google account, right? And then you're also given access to even get started, which is in the lab, right? So I'm going to show you how to literally go through your measures and how to get started, guys. So come on, let's get right in, guys. Let's start this and let's get building and let's build out a measure. Pretty much not build out a measure, but literally let's just really look at how measures are being used in Google Luca and Camel. So let's get started, guys. So right now you can see this is my tab. My tab is open in here, and to get started, I'm going to this search here. So I'm just going to click Luca Quick Labs, and here you can see I have Luca Developer Quick Starts. Gonna click that, and yeah, you literally have to sign in to get started with Google Luca. So you can either sign in using your Google email address, right? Sign in, and I think for every user, I actually have like 5 trials on Quick Labs if I'm right, but let's see this and let's get started. So I'm gonna sign in, I'm gonna start lab, and I'm not a robot. I'm gonna open Luca in a new tab here, and I have my username as well as also my password. I'm gonna copy this, I'm gonna paste. Apparently, I was already logged in, so I guess that's why it probably allowed me. I'm not sure. But I'm just gonna get started, right? The whole point of this is to literally show you what measure is and how to literally understand how to use a measure, right? So we're gonna click explore, and we're gonna click events. Let me see if other items has something useful, right? We're gonna click others, and we're gonna see the different measures here. Okay, let's use other items, right? So understand that this is pretty much other items, and if I click in here, I can look and understand how it's been generated, like this field called inventory ID. But our concern in here is really not about this field. Our concern in here is really about the measures. So I'm gonna click here. I can see this is a measure as highlighted in here. Click here, and I'm going to go to LookML. And in doing this, we're going to see that we have different measures in here. I'm gonna try and increase this. So in here, you're seeing that we have a measure here, and that's how to actually define the measure, right? And we're also seeing that it's called average sales price, and this is pretty much what is here. It's called average sales price in here, right? And we also see that it also has a type of average. Now I'm going to show you through how the different measure type is being used here, right? Here we're using something called an average, but we also have like other alternative to literally specify the type of measure you want to perform. Do you want to measure? Do you want to use a date? Do you want to use accounts? Do you want to use an average, right? All these are different measures that can literally employ using Google Luca, right? In here. and this is literally done in your UKML view pretty much, right? So we're using an average in here to literally calculate the average sales price for other items, and we're using the SQL column called sale price. Now remember that there's something called a sale price up top. So this is called a sale price in here, and sale price is already defined by specifying the data type or the column called sale price in the table, and the table is nothing but this table that we are seeing here. And because it's a demo data, it's pretty much called cloud training demo, blah blah blah, right? And we're scrolling down in here, and we're seeing that we've already referenced the sale price up top here, and that's what we're referencing in here, right? As the average sale price. And we're also drilling the fields. So to even understand what the different features that we're using, Google Lookup helps us understand this and literally gives us an idea of what is even a type. What does it do? It says that type specifies the sale value type of this field, right? What does the SQL do? SQL declares the SQL expression used to define the value of this field. So even in SQL, you can even perform a case when statement in UKML view as well, so right? Your drill fields as well. So it says drill field parameter specifies which field will be drilled into when a user clicks on a cell for this field, right? Also, you also understand what the value format is, and it specifies USD_O. So I believe what this means is that you're specifying how the values should be formatted. So let's see an example. So what my understanding of this is, because I mean, this is my first time, of how this will work is that it will pretty much give you an output but also append the USD dollar sign, I guess so, but let's see whether that's true or not. So I'm gonna go back here. Let me select this average price measure and let's see. But I think it's going to flag an error. I'm not sure because it didn't flag an error. So what you can see here is that this USD_ format that we actually specified in here, right? It literally allows us to specify the dollar format, like append the dollar sign just before the value itself. And I mean, personally, this is a new learning for me. I'm just literally seeing this for the first time. So I've literally learned something just by even creating this video, guys. So I'm really stunned that this is actually possible. This is a new knowledge for me. But yeah, you can actually specify or even append a dollar amount just by specifying the USD or the currency type as seen in here, right? And that's pretty much what the value format does. Moving right up, we're going to actually see or understand how other different measures can be used as well too. In here, we just literally spoke about the average type. We're also going to see understand how different type like count as well too, as well as how to even use sum as well, right? So let's pretty much just look at sum. So sum here just tells us what the total revenue is, and they're literally adding the sales price, which literally gives you the revenue in this context, right? It tells us the revenue, and I literally would also want to see how this also bring this as. For example, we notice that with USD_, it literally shows us the amount as just 46, right? But we're just specifying only USD alone. Let's see, understand what this does pretty much, right? We're going to check the total revenue, and we're going to bring it in here, and it's called total revenue in here, and I'm going to run this as well, and let's see. Okay, so now we understand the difference. The total revenue with the USD just as is in here, right, pretty much gives us the full value of the total revenue. And I'm going to try and pretty much increase this clearly. So in here, we see that when we specify USD as is, we are having the full value. It's also specifying the decimal as well too. But when we just have USD_0, it's literally just only giving us the USD value. Neat trick, guys. I'm so excited I've actually learned this new thing. It's really, I mean, for someone who works with a lot of like data when it comes to even the amount, right, or even like revenue as well, so as well as sales price and the likes, this has literally come in handy for me personally as new learning point. So one interesting trick I've learned, I'm so excited about it. Let's scroll down and see what other thing we can see in here. So we're going to scroll down here. I'll also love to also show you this as well, right? We can also see something called the total revenue from completed orders, and that is what it's in here. That's total revenue from completed orders, and by just looking at it, we can literally understand what this means, right? It's literally telling us, give us the total sum sum of the sale price when it has the status of complete. Note that we pretty much will be able to understand it when we actually look at all the data sets or other data points that is present. Even if you don't look at it, you can actually deduce what the status is. So it shows in here that we are filtering this particular measure by specifying that the status should be complete. So it means that it has different status, right? It could be incomplete, in progress, whatsoever, right? But in this case, we only want to have it when the status is actually complete. Another thing in here is you can actually just use a SQL and use a case where statement to specify select the sales price when the status is complete. But yeah, because we can filter, it makes sense for us to actually use a status complete for this purpose. And that's what this does. So this gives us the total revenue from a complete order. And if I literally just click this value in here as well too, and I run this, let's see what we get. So we are seeing that we have only the completed orders and we have about 7.3. So it just goes to show that even the difference between 7.7 and 7.3 could be the other orders that probably have different status as well too. So hey guys, I've literally like showed you like the most important thing to even understand and take note of when you want to build a measure, right? If at all you're just getting started and you need sort of like some guidance as to like some questions just to even get through using Google Looker, I know it can be a lot of understanding when it comes to learning how it works. Please ensure to reach out, ensure to please also like this video as well so you've also gained value from this. Also ensure to also comment as well to share this video and also, you know, let every other person who is looking to learn more, understand how Google Looker work, come on board as well too, right? Until next time, ensure to have a good day guys, and ensure to please give this video a thumbs up too. Bye guys.